English subject. As you all know that English is compulsory for both commerce and science stream. So it is also very important as your other subjects. Generally, it is seen that it is considered as side by subject. You all people think that English to easy hai mere yaar, end mein ho jayega tayyar, right? But it is not like that. You must concentrate on the subject also, and you have to know about the importance of this subject also. It will raise your percentage, it will decrease your percentage. So you all have to come out of this misconception that English will be prepared at the end of the year, and you do your best for the subject also. Clear? So before talking about the subject and syllabus and marking scheme and all, first of all, we must know the importance of the subject and the language. Why English is important in our life? What you can do to improve your language skills? I know that there are lots of students, there are lots of people who are from vernacular medium or Hindi medium or any other medium. So in starting, they may face some problems in understanding. But from the starting, you have to understand this language in this language only. There are lots of people or students who are unable to speak publicly, who are not able to read properly. Till now, you all have raised in the 11th standard, but still we can see the students that they are not able to understand or they are not able to read in front of the other people. So what you can do for that? For that, you have to improve your skills in this language. There are listening skills, reading skills, writing skills, and speaking skills. These are the four main skills you have to improve by yourself. Nowadays, we are at the platform, digital platform, where you have to listen. So first of all, you have to improve the listening skill in yourself. You have to listen to the person who is speaking so that you can improve your language skill. Second, reading skill. You just take a paragraph, read aloud, and in this way, you can improve your reading skill. Then writing skill. Make a practice of writing the language. You have to practice at home from starting so that you can improve your writing skill also. And last but not least, that is speaking skills. In speaking skills, from starting, you have to present yourself. There are lots of methods. There are lots of things that you can improve your speaking skills also. So what you can do to improve the language, to improve your communication skills? We are going to talk about the syllabus and chapters and the books and all the things. But first of all, we must know the importance of the subject, because many times I see that you people consider it as a side-by-side subject. When this subject will keep you side-by-side, you will never know. So it will increase your percentage and it will decrease your percentage also. So what you can do to improve your vocabulary, to improve your personality? Bookish knowledge is not enough to grace your personality. For that, you have to improve the overall development, right? So what you can do, you can take 2 words daily, and you can use them in your daily routine life while speaking. You start with the small sentences. You start to speak in the small sentences. What you can do, you can stand in front of the mirror and you can read aloud. So in this way, you will improve your reading skills also. Because the person, the people who are from vernacular medium, they have the hesitation, they have the fear that they are not able to speak or they are not able to read. You have to remove this hesitation and you have to remove this fear from your inside that you can do anything. So we are talking about that why English is important nowadays. I tell you some things that why it is important. With proper knowledge on English fluency, you can strong your career from the initial stage. You all have taken the admission in junior college. Right now you are in FYJC, commerce and science, both the students are there. So you can strong, you can build your career from your initial stage. You have chosen the commerce stream and science stream. By thinking something, you have already chosen these subjects that you want to become this and you want to become that. So from the starting, from the initial stage, the knowledge of English fluency, the knowledge of English language, you can strong your career. Secondly, as English is being used as official language in many countries, so speaking English fluency makes you easier to communicate at any level. Nowadays, we can see that everything is communicated in English only, like seminars, conferences, client meetings, wherever you are going, you are using the language English. Third, English helps you to roam around the world for business or higher education. Now you have grown up people or grown up person. So you are growing and your education, higher education will be definitely in English only. Without any hesitation and without any fear, you can communicate with other people. You can easily get involved in the people from new environment. Means you, wherever you are going, wherever you are talking, whenever you are talking with anyone, you are not feeling any kind of fear or any kind of hesitation. So if you will improve the skills, you can communicate with anywhere, anyone. The fourth thing is, nowadays we can see that in this present scenario, we can see that everything is online and we are also on the same platform, right? We are also taking the knowledge through this platform. Teaching learning method has also become digital. So here also we require this language. Most of the content which is available on the internet is also in English. Whether you are going to websites or you are watching any videos or you are searching on Google, anything, anywhere, we are using the language English. So there is so much content that is not easily translated into other languages. Okay, so if we find that we want the material in Tamil language, we cannot easily find it on the internet. So everything, every content is easily available in English language. As we all know that it is widely spoken in the whole world. It is understood by all easily or communicated easily. So in this way, we come to know that why English is important nowadays in our day-to-day life. Having English language skills increases your chances of getting a good job in multinational companies or in foreign countries. Okay, you have chosen the commerce and science stream by thinking someone. Okay, so you are planning for your future. You want your future bright. So that you have chosen these subjects. So someone wants to do CA, CS, someone else want to do something in science stream. So everyone's dream is to do work in multinational companies or in foreign countries. So for that also we require this language. You can present yourself. It will improve your personality. Okay, using English, by using communication in English, you can also improve your personality. So here we discussed about the importance of the subject and language. Understood? I think it is clear. Now we proceed to the introduction part. Introduction not about you and me. We will do our introduction later. When our college is about to open, we will introduce ourselves. The introduction is about your textbook, syllabus, marking scheme, and each and everything. On screen, you can see that there is the cover page of your textbook. Why I'm showing this? because the whole year passes, the students are not known about the textbook of them. They don't know that this is the English textbook. As I already told you that it is considered as a side-by-side subject. Okay, so I'm telling you, I'm warning you again and again that if you will keep this subject side-by-side, this subject will keep you side-by-side. Okay, so you have to also give the importance of this subject. So this is the cover page of your subject. Never judge a book by its cover. The proverb suits here. Introduction about not you and me. Okay, this is the cover page as I told you. And I told you that why I am showing it. Now we proceed to the next slide. The whole book is divided into four parts. Okay, so first of all, you must know about the content and why about the chapters and in which portion it is divided. The textbook is divided into four parts. Section 1, Section A, that is prose. Section B, that is poetry. Section C, that is writing skills. Okay, so first of all, we will talk about Section A, that is prose. Prose section, there are some chapters. Yes, section 1 is divided into prose section. Here we can see that there are 6 chapters. 1.1, being neighborly. 1.2, on to the summit, we reach the top. 1.3, the call of the soil. 1.4, pillars of democracy. 1.5, Mrs. Addis. And 1.6, Tiger Hills. As you can see here that I have marked 1.1 with red font. Why it is? Because it is omitted from your syllabus. The chapter being neighborly, please mark it that it is omitted from your syllabus. You people are very lucky enough that there are only 5-10 chapters. In previous syllabus, there were 32 or 37 chapters. So the syllabus has been removed. The chapters now, because of the present scenario, the chapter is being removed from here, from the prose section. There is a wonderful blend of essays, short stories, biographical sketches, speeches, and articles in the prose section of the book. Care has been taken to choose inspiring pieces of literature written by well-known authors, which will not only inculcate a wholesome sense of right and wrong in pupils, but also sensitize students to the pleasure and pain of life. The ultimate goal of these prose pieces is that through familiarity with these texts, students will be motivated to express themselves in the various forms of prose they are exposed to in the course book. So in this prose section, you will come to know the beautiful stories. The beautiful stories are woven in the prose section. Now, how will be the marking scheme of the prose section? I'll let you know. In section 1, prose, we can see that there will be 2 questions. Okay, how the questions will be asked and how many marks are for that? The prose section carries 34 marks. For the whole academic year, it carries 34 marks. There will be 2 questions. Question number 1, A and B. Question number 2, A, B and C. In this way, they are divided. Okay? question number 1A. In that question, you will be given an extract from the textbook. There are 5 chapters. As I already told you that chapter number 1.1 is already omitted from your syllabus. So there are only 5 chapters left. So there will be an extract from the syllabus, scene extract from the syllabus, and the questions are based on that scene extract. Here I want to tell you one thing, that you people find the question, a word in a question, and you find that word in the passage and you are supposed to write that answer. It is not like that. Now your level has been changed. So you have to think logically. Without thinking logically, you are not supposed to give the answers. So in scene extract, question number 1A, there will be 6 questions. Okay. Each question carries 2 marks. One is, I'm telling you the questions. First is global understanding. The second will be complex factual. The third will be inference. Then personal response. Then language study and the vocabulary. Vocabulary will be asked from that particular passage only. It is not from the outside. So you must come to know that these are the questions will be asked. Global understanding, complex factual, each question carries 2 marks. Understood? Here, the second part will be the B part, where you will be asked the questions related to the grammar. Like, do as directed, transformation of sentences, and B2, spot the error. Okay, so you will be given the questions related to grammar. In grammar, there are lots of topics included, like tenses, active passive voice, direct indirect, and so on. So in this way, you will be asked the questions from these grammar topics. The second one will be spot the error. Means you will be given the sentence, a wrong sentence. You have to find the mistake in that sentence and correct it. So in this way, in question number 1, we can see that there are 6 questions in all in A part, and there are 2 questions in B part. Okay. So these 6 questions carries 16 marks, 12 marks, and B section carries 4 marks. So in all, this question number 1 carries 16 marks. Okay. So this question ends here. Now the second question, section, we are talking about only section A, that is prose section. We are just talking about it. The question number 2 will be unseen extract. Unseen extract, it may be asked from anywhere. Okay, unseen extract, that means it is not included from your textbook. It is not from the textbook, that is unseen passage. This question divided into 3 parts, A, B, and C. So it carries 18 marks. Question number 1 carries 16 marks, and question number 2 carries 18 marks. How? The question based on the unseen passage, there will be 6 questions. Again, in the same manner, global understanding, complex factual, inference, personal response, language study, and vocabulary. They are all based on the unseen extract. In the B part of this question, there will be a question of summary writing. Means you have to write the summary of the above extract with a suitable title with the help of the given points. You will be given the helping points to write the summary of the above passage. Means you have to write the same summary of the same passage, unseen passage. There will be no any separate passage to write the summary. Okay. It carries 3 marks. And the third one, सी सी सेक्शन में आपको रहेगा नोट मेकिंग. नोट मेकिंग इट इज अ कंप्लीशन ऑफ द टास्क. ओके, अ पैसेज विल बी गिवन टू यू. इन दैट सम फिल इन द ब्लैंक्स विल बी गिवन और एनी अदर फॉर्मेट विल बी गिवन. यू हैव टू फाइंड आउट द आंसर्स फ्रॉम द पैसेज एंड यू हैव टू कंप्लीट दैट नोट मेकिंग. So it is also read the given extract and complete the given activity as per the instruction. So in this way, we come to know that section A carries 34 marks. Got it? I think it is clearly understood to you all. So section 1, that is known as prose section. I told you that there are only 5 chapters. One chapter, that is 1.1, being neighborly, is omitted from your syllabus. You not need to read that chapter. Only there are remaining 5 chapters. From these 5 chapters, there will be a scene extract, one scene extract and one unseen extract. This prose section carries 34 marks. I have already told you about the dividation of the all the marks. Now, come to the second section. Second section, that is poetry. A fresh addition to teaching and learning poetry is summarizing appreciation and composition of a few lines of poetry. This would enhance the joy of learning poetry and lend beauty and rhythm to the daily uses of the language. See, if you will read English, it is also very, very interesting. You will find the language enjoyable for you all. If you will go to read, to learn, to speak, you will find this language, this subject also very interesting. The section B is known as poetry section. You all are familiar about the poems. Here, beautiful poems are included in the syllabus. Now we will talk about the second section, that is poetry section. It carries 14 marks. This particular part is divided into 14 marks. Here, again, I would like to tell you. Yes, these are all the poems which are included in your course book. The Cherry Tree, The Sower, There Is Another Sky, Upon Westminster Bridge, Nose Versus Eyes, and The Planners. Again, here you can see that I highlighted the last poem, that is The Planners, Boy Kim Cheng. It is also removed from your syllabus. It is omitted from the syllabus to see the current situation because of the present scenario. So it is also removed from your syllabus. So I just want to tell you, I just want to inform you that you all are very lucky enough that already you have less syllabus, and from that also you are reducing the chapters also. So you have to read only 5 poems. So in this way, you just go through deeply into the poem, into the chapters. You must try to understand the chapters. You learn the theme of the chapters. So you will get enjoy while reading these chapters. So here we can see that only 5 poems are there. The Cherry Tree, The Sower, There Is Another Sky, Upon Westminster Bridge, and Nose Versus Eyes. So this last one, this the planner is also omitted from your syllabus. So we were talking about this poetry section. Here again, the questions, how the questions will be asked. Okay. So question number 3A, a scene extract from the given, from the poem in your question paper about the lines of the poems will be given. So you have to attempt the questions based on that poem. There will be 5 questions: global understanding, inference, personal response, poetic device, and creativity. these last two questions are very interesting. Okay, so three questions are based on the poem. The poem will be given to you in the question paper. 8 to 10 lines will be given there, and you have to write the answers of the questions. The third one is personal response. That means, what did you get? What did you understand by that poem? So you have to write the answer from your own. The fourth one is poetic device. We know that there are lots of poetic devices used by the poets to enrich, to make beautiful the poem. So there are lots of poetic devices like simile, pun, metaphor, alliteration, repetition, ode. So in this way, we use such kind of poetic devices. So you will be asked the question related to the poetic devices. The lines will be given to you. You have to find out the name of the poetic device and you have to explain it. Or you have to create a poem on that particular poetic device. Okay. The last question is of creativity. It means how your mind is more imaginative, how you can think. This is improve your logical thinking, your creativity, your imaginative thinking. So you can also compose 2 or 3 lines by your own on the based of the theme of the poem. जो भी poem आपको दी जाती है उसकी theme के basis पे you have to create your own poem particular lines. Clear? So in this way there are 5 questions will be asked. Each question carries 2 marks. That means first poem carries 10 marks. Okay? This is compulsory to attend. You have to write on the attempt all the questions related to this poem. Now the second question from this particular section, B part, okay, poetry section, there will be 2 questions. One question, as I told you, that the lines will be given to you, you have to write the answer. The questions will be asked based on that lines, and you have to write the answer of the question. What will be the second question? The second question, appreciation. Okay, you are familiar about this term, critical appreciation. Here again, you will read the extract and you have to write as per the instructions. Okay, this poem will be the different poem. It is not the poem that is asked in the question number A. Means there will be 2 poems will be asked simultaneously. Okay, so you have to write the critical appreciation of the particular poem. It means you have to prepare for all the critical appreciation. Means there are now 5 poems in your syllabus. So you have to prepare all the critical appreciation of the particular poems, so that any poem question can be come and you are able to attempt that. So I think that you all are fully understood by these 2 sections. First is section A, that is prose sections. As I already told you, there are 6 chapters in your syllabus, but 1 chapter, that is being neighborly, is omitted from your syllabus. Second one, the section B, that is poetry section. Here again, you have 6 poems, but 1 poem, the planner, is omitted from the syllabus. I have told you about the marking scheme of the prose section and the poetry section. Now we proceed to the third section. Section C, that is writing skill. Okay, as I told you that writing skill is very important part of English language. By writing skills, you can improve your vocabulary, you can improve your thinking, you can improve your everything. So you have to practice from starting. स्टार्टिंग से ही आपको प्रैक्टिस करना है. दीज ऑल द राइटिंग स्किल्स विल बी कैरीड टू द 12th स्टैंडर्ड ऑल्सो. Somehow only one or two, three topics will be changed in 12th standard. Otherwise, all these topics will be same. So from right now, you are in right now FYJC 11th standard. So you can practice from right now. अभी से आप practice करेंगे तो ही you will get good marks in your writing skills. In the third section, examples of the various writing skills which we expect the student to learn are included. Through these examples, we can hone the writing skills of the various forms discussed in the course book. ICT-based writing skills such as email writing and blog writing also have been intentionally introduced. To look into the present scenario, to look into the future generation, some new topics are introduced right now, like email and blog writing. Okay, these are the part of this writing skills. Now we will discuss about this writing skills topic. Okay. Now these are all the topics which are included in your writing skills. First is expansion of idea, blog writing, emails, interview, film review, the art of comparing. These are the topics which are mentioned in your textbook. Okay, so ये जो topics हैं ये आपके textbook जो है वहाँ पे mention है. They are included in your course book. Then I have written A, B, C, and D. In this format, the questions will be asked. How? Means question number A, question number B, question C, and question D. In this format, the third section, as I told you, is known as writing skills. This carries 16 marks. Each and every question carries 4 marks. Okay, so here I have mentioned, these are the about, it is written 3.1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. These are the topics included in your course book and the rest of the topics which are included in your syllabus. On these topics, the question will be asked. So these are the 4 questions. In this format, you will be asked the questions. First question will be of email writing or letter writing. Second question will be of expansion of idea or blog writing or film review. The C section is appeal writing, leaflet writing, report writing, view and counterview section. And the D one is speech writing, comparing, dialogue writing and interview. Now we come to the topics. As I told you that it carries 16 marks. Okay. Every question carries 4 marks. There will be 4 questions will be asked to you all in this format. Question number A, B, C and D. In this format, you will be asked the questions and each question carries 4 marks. Now, I would like to clear your doubt that all these options will be given or not. Okay, so here you can see that question number A, email and letter writing, both the options will be given. In 11th standard, it depends upon the examiner or paper setter that they are giving you the all the options or they are giving you 2 or 3 options. But in boards, you will find all the options. Okay, so you will have to prepare only 1 or 2 writing skills. You are easily able to attempt all the questions. So here you will get all the options in writing skills. So this is your choice that which writing skill part you want to write, you want to attempt. The first question will be of email or letter writing. In your syllabus, only letter writing is in letter writing, only formal letter is included, not informal. Okay. Previously it was formal and informal. Both the letters are included, but now you have only formal letters. In that option, you have email writing. In writing skill, each and every writing skill has its own format, how to write it. Okay, so you must know about the each and every format of the writing skill. First, we will talk about the expansion of idea. I think you all are aware about this topic. Expansion of idea. Here, you will be given a topic or a proverb. You have to explain or you have to elaborate it in your own words. Just like a topic is given to you, a bad workman blames his tools. You have to elaborate it. It is a proverb. One should eat to live, not live to eat. It is a proverb. You have to elaborate it. If winter comes, can spring be far behind? These are some famous quotes written by famous writers. So, such kind of quotes will be also given to you in expansion of ideas. Beauty is truth, truth is beauty by John Keats. So in this way, these are the quotes, these are the proverbs will be given to you and you have to elaborate it, you have to expand it in your own words. So this is the expansion of idea. Here, in expansion of idea, you will develop your imaginative thinking. Okay, you are going to develop your imaginary mind. You have to think over the topic from the various angles. Okay, you are going to express your experiences related to that topic. Okay, so you have to narrate it into your own words. Expansion of ideas expects writers to think deeply and imaginatively. Why? To get the inner meaning of the sentence and the full significance you have to write. It is basically a writing activity where you all are expected to write on the given topic with examples or explanation. You can also share your experience. You can also give an example. You can also explain it. Okay. So a quotation or a voice thought may be asked. Clear? I think expansion of idea is clear to you all. Now we come to the second topic, that is blog writing. This term is new to all. New to you all. Okay. What is a blog writing? A blog is an article on a topic expressing the views, experiences, or feelings of a person. Writing a blog is really a challenging thing to do. A person who writes a blog, he is known as blogger. So on social media, blog writing is written on social media. We come to know that there are lots of people who are bloggers. You also read the blogs of the famous personalities, famous or all the celebrities who write their thoughts on the blog. So there is also a format of writing a blog writing. Okay, on internet, on social media, we express our thoughts, we express our experiences, views on internet. That is known as blog writing. So we are getting the opportunity to communicate with the people on social media. It is a platform where we can share our views on the particular topic. Okay, so blog writing also has its own format. एक अपना एक तरह का होता है, उसका एक अपना format होता है. तो उसे हमें कैसे किस format में लिखना है, वो we will come to know it about later. Now we come to the next topic, that is emails. You all are very much familiar, very much known about this topic. Nowadays, everything is computerized. And everything, the communication way is through the emails. So while writing an email, it is also known as electronic mail. It is the modern and one of the most commonly used service on the internet to send personal and professional messages. Okay, we can send the messages through these emails. For that, what we require? We require a personal email address. You can create your email ID on any website. Like you can create on Yahoo, you can create on Google, or you can create on Rediff. So we require, first of all, we require the email address while exchanging the messages. Email is an authentic mail or proof that we are communicating with the other people. Okay. Now, come to the next writing skill. That is interview. In interview writing, you are supposed to take an interview of a famous personality. Okay. So, what is the format of the interview writing? In interview writing, we are supposed to ask the questions only. We are not going to give the answers of these questions. When you are going to take an interview of a famous personality or any social worker or any other people, you must have to ask the questions only. You must have to frame the questions only. You are not need to write the answers of the questions given by the interviewer. So in this writing skill, in this format, we have to frame the questions only. Now, the next most interesting topic, that is film review. Film review is again newly added in your syllabus. What is film review? Film review is an analysis and evaluation of a film from viewer point of view. You are a critic. Okay, we watch many movies. We see in cinemas and sometimes we find that this movie is good, that movie is bad and so on. So what we are? We are the critics. So while watching a movie, we are going to give the review of that movie. In Times of India also, you will find that there is the rating of the movie. 2-star rating, 3-star rating, 4 or 5-star rating. So by that rating, we can judge that this movie is going to be very nice movie or this movie is going to be very bad movie. A film review writer points out good and bad elements about the film. Okay, so now nowadays number of films are produced on various social issues. So it is very difficult for us to watch each and every movie. So by reviewing a movie, we can judge that we have to watch it and we should not have to watch it. So while reviewing, film reviewing, what we required? Here in this topic, you are free to write the review of any movie of your choice. In this question, you will not be given the particular movie or write on the film review of that particular movie. You are feel free to write the review of any movie by your choice. You can choose Three Idiots, you can choose Tare Zameen Par, which gives us some social message. There are lots of movies which gives us messages to our society. So you can also choose a movie by your own and you can write the film review of that movie. So what are the topics would be covered while writing the film review? You must cover the plot analysis, the genre, the script writer, the acting, the direction, the music and sound, cinematography, characterization, everything, all the, and the message, the film, what the film is giving you the message. So by these topics, you have to cover up all the topics, and by these topics, you can write the review of a film. So this is going to be very interesting topic. ये भी हमारे एक सिलेबस में बहुत ही इंटरेस्टिंग टॉपिक ऐड हुआ है. लास्ट बट नॉट लीस्ट, द आर्ट ऑफ कंपेयरिंग. व्हाई दीज टॉपिक्स आर एडेड? देर आर लॉट्स ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स अमंग योरसेल्फ दैट हु वांट्स टू बिकम एन एंकर, हु वांट्स टू बिकम अ डायरेक्टर, हु वांट्स टू बिकम एनीथिंग एल्स. सो From starting, you must create, you must inculcate with these qualities so that you can improve yourself. So the art of comparing, it is also very, very interesting topic. You know, अभी तो ये जो हमारा जो situation चल रहा है, इस हिसाब से we are not celebrating any programs in our colleges. Otherwise, you have lots of programs in your colleges, like cultural program, freshers party, you all are missing. I know that you all are missing these days and these functions. So whenever we will resume to our colleges, we will definitely celebrate these functions also. So it is the part of these functions, the art of comparing. That means comparing, that means an act of a comparer. Host means you are hosting a program. You are the anchor. You are celebrating an event. Okay, so the art of comparing is also a writing skill. What you have to do in it? You have to create, a program list of that particular function. Means, suppose we are celebrating a freshers party in our college. Okay, so first of all, we have to create the program list for that particular function. Means the welcoming of the guest, felicitation of the guest, dance performed by the SYJC student, then drama performing. So in this way, you have to ready the, you have to prepare the program list. Okay, after the finalizing of the program list, you have to write a script of the particular function. Means you are going to introduce with yourself with the audience. Okay, so these are the particular program list, and on the particular function you are going to host the program. So what will be the qualities of the anchor? Okay, so for that you have to be very attentive. Your presence of mind should be there. How you will communicate with the audience, you have to be very knowledgeable on that particular topic, and you have to show your confidence. You have to show your confidence in front of the public. You should be very, very appropriate about your body language. And there is also should be a sense of humor in you so that you can interact with the audience, you can keep touch with the audience. So these are all the topics included in your writing skills. These are mentioned in the textbook. ये आपकी textbook में mention किए हुए हैं. And as I told you that A, B, C and D, these are the questions. On this topic, the question will be asked. In question number A, email and letter writing will be there. All the questions you will get the option here. Second is expansion of idea, blog writing and film review. We all discussed about these topics. Again, here you will get all these three options, and you will have to attempt only one question. Question number C, that is appeal, leaflet, report writing, and view counterview. These are all the topics that are not mentioned in your textbook, but still they are included in your syllabus. Now, what is appeal writing? I think you all are aware about this appeal writing. Appeal writing is a topic, particular topic in which you are going to appeal to the in publicly on the particular topic, like eye donation camp. So you are going to appeal to the people that donate your eyes. You have to tell the importance of the donating of the eyes, how your eyes can help to the other people who are blind. So in this way, you have to appeal to the people. There is also a format of writing and appeal writing. Okay. So as when we will discuss further, we will let you know. I will let you know about the each and every one's format, because हर एक राइटिंग स्किल का अपना एक अलग फॉर्मेट है. यू हैव टू फॉलो दैट फॉर्मेट ओनली एंड यू आर सपोज टू राइट इन दैट फॉर्मेट ओनली. बिकॉज वाइल राइटिंग स्किल्स यू विल गेट द मार्क्स ऑफ प्रेजेंटेशन ऑल्सो. हाउ यू आर प्रेजेंटिंग योर राइटिंग स्किल्स. द सेकेंड वन इज लीफलेट. इट इज जस्ट लाइक पैम्पलेट. ओके. सो लीफलेट इज मे बी हिस्टोरिकल लीफलेट or religious leaflet or hill station leaflet. Means you will be given a topic. On that particular topic, you are supposed to write how to go there, where to stay, accommodation, the special features of that place. So prior, you have to prepare the information about any particular place. As I told you, there are three types of places. One is historical, second is religious, third is hill station. So historical place, if you will be asked that about the historical place, you are supposed to write about only like Agra, Delhi. Okay. And when you are asked about the religious place, so you are supposed to write about the Shirdi, Badrinath, Kedarnath. And the third one is hill station, so you are supposed to write about only Ooty, Manali, Jammu Kashmir, Lonavala, such kind of places. So prior you collect the information about these places and prepare the leaflet prior, so that it will not take a burden during the examination. Next is report writing. While writing a report, you must also know about the format of writing a report. How to write a report? रिपोर्ट मस्ट बी ऑलवेज इन पास्ट टेंस. बिकॉज रिपोर्ट कभी लिखते हैं, जब भी हमारा ऑलरेडी द इंसिडेंट हैड ऑलरेडी टेकन ना, दैट देन ओनली वी राइट द रिपोर्ट. सो एवरी टाइम वेन एवर यू आर राइटिंग रिपोर्ट, यू योर सेंटेंसेज मस्ट बी इन द पास्ट टेंस. ओके. सो देर इज ऑल्सो अ फॉर्मेट ऑफ राइटिंग द रिपोर्ट. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू हैव टू राइट द हेडलाइन, देन सेकेंड इज डेडलाइन, then introductory paragraph, and then leading paragraph. Headlines, that means you have to write the heading of the report writing. Then deadline, in deadline you have to write the information about the place, time, and by whom it is written. Then we come to the leading paragraph, introductory paragraph. It means you have to give the information about that incident, and the leading paragraph. The next is view counterview section. In this section, in view section, you will be given some points and you have to write for the counterview section. Means a topic will be given to you and the some points will be given to that topic. So what you have to do, you have to write opposite the topic which is given, whether you are agree or not. Means you have to write the opposite. You have to write in the paragraph form. So this is also a part of writing skill. So in this way, we can see that here you are having four options. So the examiner or the paper setter can give you three options or all the four options. So the best part of the writing skill is that you are given lots of choices. Here you have lots of choices. So this is the best part of writing skill. But you have to attempt all the questions. Question number A carries 4 marks. Question number B carries 4 marks. C also carries 4 marks and D also carries 4 marks. In D section, we have speech writing, comparing, dialogue writing, and interview. We have discussed about the interview and comparing. In speech writing, you are also again here given a topic. On that particular topic, you have to give the speech. There are lots of programs on which we have to give the speech. Here it is also, we have some introductory format of this speech writing. Okay. Now, last but not least, that is dialogue writing. Dialogue is a conversation between two people. The topic may be anyone, and you are supposed to write the dialogue of the particular topic. Okay, so in this way, we can see that we have discussed about the writing skills. So, as I told you that section 1, section 2, and section 3. Okay, section 1 is prose section. It is called as section A. Section B, that is poetry section. Section C, that is writing skill. It carries 16 marks. So in this way, till now, we have seen that section A carries 34 marks. Section B carries 14 marks. And section C carries 16 marks. Now come to the last section, that is section D. It is newly introduced to you all. That is drama. Okay. Drama is very interesting introduced here. What sets this course book apart is section 4, in which the pupil will have a glimpse of the genre of drama, an exciting and captivating branch of literature. Some extracts from well-loved and popular plays and some thought-provoking examples from the genre have been included. It is an interesting mix of plays having historical, socio-cultural, and comic themes, representative of this form of literature. Therefore, friends, with this course book, we embark on a new and exciting voyage. Let us enjoy the expedition together. Means the whole book is beautifully woven to keep in mind to all the students. Okay, so if you will create a sense of humor, if you will create an interest in yourself, you will find so much enjoy while reading these chapters and drama part also. So what is, we generally use the term dramebaz, right? You also say to your friends that kya drama kar raha hai, bahut zyada dramebaz hai, bahut natak aa gaye hain aapko, hai na? In this way, we use such kind of words. So drama is basically just like we are performing something, overreacting. Drama is a poetic composition that is acted in front of the audience. Okay, we are overreacting. Okay, so this is known as drama. So here 4 chapters are included in your drama part. History of English drama, The Rising of the Moon, Extracts of Drama, that is A Midsummer Night's Dream, written by William Shakespeare, An Enemy of the People, Henrik John Ibsen. So these are all the drama part in section 4. Now I tell you detail about this drama part. how the questions will be asked in this section. This is the fourth section. Okay, drama part is your fourth section. It also carries 16 marks. 4.1, 4.2, 4.3. In 4.3 we have two part, A and B. So each chapter carries 4 marks. History of English drama, there will be the questions asked for 4 marks. The Rising of the Moon also carries 4 marks. A Midsummer Night's Dream, again 4 marks. And Enemy of the People, 4 marks. The best thing of the writing skill was that you have lots of choices. Okay. But here you might be little bit sad. Why? Because in this section, you will not be given any passage. Getting my point? You will not be given any passage to find the answers. So what you have to do? You have to read the whole drama thoroughly. Getting my point? Sorry. So here you have to read all the chapters deeply, thoroughly. And you have to understand the theme, summary, story, because the questions may be asked from anywhere. You are not going to give the passes here, so directly the questions will be asked from the chapter. So you might be having sadness in yourself that हमारे तो English तो हम तो ऐसे ही करते हैं कि passage आ जाता है and then we find the question answers from that passage. It is not like that. So you have to all have to come out of this misconception that English is very easy. It is not like that. It is not so easy as you all think. Okay. So in this drama part, you have to read each and every chapter thoroughly, deeply. How the questions will be asked. Now, 4.1. Okay. So here, the question, there will be two questions asked. Okay. Here again, you will be given the activities. Activities in the sense that you may be asked the questions like true or false. You will be given the fill in the blanks. You will be asked by the match the following question. In this way, you will ask the questions. So activities to be framed on the MCQs. As I told you, match the column and fill in the blanks and elements of the drama. Okay, so such kind of questions will be asked for 2 mark. Clear? This is the question will be asked from this drama part. Question number B means each and every chapter carries 4 marks. Now I told you only about the 2 mark. Now rest of the 2 mark, you have to answer in about 50 words to the question given below. Okay, so the question will be framed on the elements like plot, structure, theme, setting, language, character. You have to, you are supposed to ask the character sketch of the particular topic. कोई भी main character आपको दे दिया, protagonist दे दिया, या sub characters आपको दे दिए गए. तो you may be asked the questions on the such kind of themes. Okay, so first question will be of MCQs and the second question you have to write the answer like 50 words. It is based on the theme and character and the plot. Clear? This is the first chapter question. 4 mark. Now the second one, the Rising of the Moon. Again here questions to be framed on elements, plot, structure, settings. Okay. Then the second question will be of interpret, narrate, justify, identify, or find. Means again, the questions may be asked to the whole drama. Character, the main theme may be asked, the character sketch of the chapter may be asked. So again, here we have 2 marks question. The third one is A Midsummer's Night's Dream. That is written by William Shakespeare. So, in the same, again, passage will not be given. Two questions will be there for two marks. And in the same way, last chapter, An Enemy of the People, again, the questions of two marks will be asked. So, in all, we can see here that 4 chapters are there. Each chapter carries 4 marks. And from every chapter, we have 2 questions of 2 marks. Means there are 8 questions carrying 16 marks all. So in this way, we come to know about the whole textbook. Okay, once again, I let you know. The whole textbook is divided into 4 parts. Section A, that is prose. Section B, poetry. From prose, 1 chapter is omitted. As I told you, 1.1, being neighborly, is omitted from your syllabus. So we will start from the next chapter on to the summit. We reach the top. Okay, this is first chapter is omitted. You have only 5 chapters. Section B, poetry is there. Again, 1 poem is also omitted from this textbook. That is The Planner. Here again, you have only 5 chapters. You have to read only 5 chapters. I'm telling you again and again that from starting, you have to learn you have to focus on this subject also. Otherwise, it will be difficult for you at the end of the year to prepare it. From starting, you must clear about the all the marking scheme, all the chapters, because I don't think that there is a lengthy syllabus for you all. If you will see the previous year's syllabus, last year it is changed. And if you will watch before last year's syllabus, there are 37 chapters there was. So how can you can imagine that you can compare yourself from them that you are lucky enough. So you have only 5 chapters from both the sections. Now in section C, writing skill. Again, I'm telling you again and again that you have to practice on the writing skills from right now. Abhi se aapko practice karna hai. Daily, you have to practice at any one writing skill. You take by your own. Aap apne hisab se koi bhi topic lijiye, you start to write on that particular topic. It will increase you will find, you will see that there is a change in yourself. You will feel confident when you will do by your own. You just think that you are doing it none for else. You are doing it only for yourself. So if you want to achieve your goal in your life, you have to start from right now. So writing skill is also a major part of your language, this English textbook. Here we have discussed lots of writing skills, lots of new and very interesting topics introduced to your textbook. And section D, that is drama. If you also have an interest in reading, you can also read the drama part. I hope that you all clearly understand these bifurcation of the marking scheme and all the topics. Now, we are going to start a chapter. That is first chapter, On to the Summit, We Reach the Top by Tenzing Norgay. Okay? I must say that you all have to purchase your textbook because we are going to read the chapters by line. Okay, so it will be easy for you all and for me also to explain and you to understand. First of all, we are starting the chapter On to the Summit, We Reach the Top, written by Tenzing Norgay. A brief introduction about the author. Tenzing Norgay, 29 May 1914, 9 May 1986, known by birth as Namgyal Wangdi and often referred to as Sherpa Tenzing, was a Nepali Indian Sherpa mountaineer. He was one of the first two individuals known to reach the summit of Mount Everest, which he accomplished with Edmund Hillary on 29 May 1953. What is the story of this chapter? Here we will come to know, it is a brief introduction about the author. And here we will come to know that Tenzing Norgay is experiencing his experiences to reach the summit of Mount Everest. Summit means highest top, the top of the mountain. So here we will know about the experiences of the writer. And he has written, "We reached the top." Why he has used "we"? Because with him, the other person was also there, whose name is Edmund Hillary. So Edmund Hillary and Tenzing Norgay are the two persons who reached the first on the top of the Mount of Everest. This extract, this passage is taken from the TOI. TOI, that means Times of India, where we can see that Tenzing Norgay himself write it. It gives us a glimpse into the thoughts of the two as they make history and their first reaction to the historic feat. Now, these are some honors and medals for their achievements. They get Tiger Medal, Star of Nepal, Padma Bhushan, and honored by Himalaya Club, King Tribhuvan, Government of India for the Everest expedition on all their achievements. Now we are going to start our chapter line by line. On to the summit, we reached the top. When we left Camp 9 on Friday morning, I was determined to get to the top on this day. That morning, I remember thinking I was to get to the top even if I die. I was not afraid to die that day. We set out early and all the way from Camp 9 to the peak, we alternated. I would take the lead and then Hillary. The man who follows when climbing has a difficult job, both in climbing up and climbing down. He is the anchor. The man going in the lead cuts the steps and breaks the way. In my pocket, I had four flags. When we were still at Camp 4, Colonel Hunt gave me three flags, those of Britain, the United Nations, and Nepal. He charged me with the duty of planting them on the top of the world. This is the first paragraph of the chapter. Here, the word determined. Determined, that means very firm. Determined, that means very firm. Alternated. Alternated means changing the places. The third one, anchor. Here, it means support. Here, Tenzing Norgay is telling us when we left Camp 9 on Friday morning. He's talking about the Camp 9. Why he's talking about the Camp 9? Because while climbing on Mount Everest, we cannot climb Mount Everest in one day. So we have to set some camps. We have to stay at some places. So they are known as the camps. So already they have reached till the Camp 9. So the distance from the camp line to the top of the Mount Everest, it was less. So when we left camp line on Friday morning, he is telling us his experiences about that. When they were leaving from the camp line on Friday morning, I was determined to get to the top on this day. He was very much firm. He was very much determined to get to the top on this day. Means on that same, on that particular day, on that very, on the very same day, he wanted to reach on the top. It means we can imagine that the distance from the camp line and the top of the mountain is not so far. That morning, I remember thinking. From that morning, I was remembering and I was thinking that I was to get to the top even if I die. And he was so firm. He was so determined that he is not care about that he would die. Means we can see that here the quality of Tenzing Norgay, that he is very much courageous. He is very much powerful. So he is saying that I was to get to the top even if I die. Agar main mar bhi jaun, to bhi mujhe koi chinta nahi hai. I was not afraid to die that day. I don't have any fear to die on that day. Means he is saying that he is courageous enough. He is saying that I am not afraid to die that day. We set out early and all the way from Camp 9. Means we prepared. Everything we have prepared and we all the way from Camp 9 to the peak, we alternated. Alternated means sometimes I was leading, sometimes Hilary was leading. Means alternated, we are changing our places. I would take the lead and then Hilary. First, I was leading. Means I was going ahead. Then Hilary was leading. The man who follows when climbing has a difficult job, both in climbing up and climbing down. Again, Tenzing Norgay is sharing his experience that when they are climbing, it is very difficult job. Who is leading? Who is climbing? It is very difficult to climb up and climb down. He is the anchor. So he is telling that he is the support person. The man going in the lead cuts the steps. The person who is leading, the person who is going ahead, he is cutting the steps and breaks the way. Means the person who is leading the way, he is making the way to go ahead. In my pocket, I had 4 flags. When we were still at Camp 4, Colonel Hunt gave me 3 flags. Those of Britain, the United Nations, and Nepal. He is telling us that when they were at the Camp 4, Colonel Hunt gave him 3 flags of the different countries. They are Britain, United Nations, and Nepal. He charged me with the duty of planting them on the top of the world. When they were leaving from there, when they were climbing to the top of the mountain, Colonel Hunt gave them the duty to plant these flags on the top of the world. So he is telling us about his experiences, that what had happened, what the other person had said to them. Come to the next one. These 3 flags are in your care, he said. When you and Hilary reach the top, put them at the peak. I'm sure that you and Hilary are going to do it. I told Colonel Hunt that I was carrying the Indian flag with me and I would like to be on the top with the other flags. I had to ask Mr. Colonel Hunt's permission in his capacity as leader of the expedition. Expedition means mission, motto. Okay, so these are three flags are in your care, he said. Who said? Mr. Colonel Hunt. Mr. Colonel Hunt said to Tenzing Hilary that I'm giving you all these 3 flags and this is your duty to place them onto the top. When you and Hilary reach the top, put them at the peak. As a symbol, you just put all the flags of these countries, just put over there. am sure that you and Hilary are going to do it. And Mr. Colonel have the faith to on Tenzing Norgay and Edmund Hillary that they are going to do this. I told Colonel Hunt that I was carrying the Indian flag with me. So Tenzing Norgay also told Colonel Hunt, I'm also carrying the Indian flag and I would like to be on the top with the other flags. And he also wants to put the Indian flag with the other country's flag. I had to ask Colonel Hunt's permission in his capacity as leader of the expedition. Why he is saying so? Because Mr. Colonel Hunt is the leader of this mission, of this motto. So he has to take the permission of Mr. Colonel Hunt. Indian flag. Colonel Hunt said, by all means, I am glad to know that you brought an Indian flag. After 1 hour of steady going, we cut across from the south face and started up the west side, where we had to pass up a steep line of rocks. This was slow and difficult. Once we had cleared these, there was nothing barring our way to top but a snow-covered incline, sloping less and less as it neared the top. Sloping, that means I have given you the meaning, slanting up and down, and steep means sharp or high. Colonel Hunt said, by all means, I am glad to know that you brought an Indian flag. Colonel Hunt also was happy that apart from these flags, he is carrying the Indian flag. After 1 hour of steady going, when they left from Camp 9, they are going steadily. We cut across from the south face and started up the west side. Means they are chasing their way from the south, where we had to pass up a steep line of rocks. Means they have to cross the steep line of a rock. This was slow and difficult. While mountaineering, we can see that we on television also, we can, when we see the adventurous people, we can see that how it is difficult to climb on the mountain. This was slow and very difficult. Once we had cleared these, there was nothing any other obstacle our way to top but a snow covered incline. There was also a very surface of snow covered, sloping less and less as it neared the top. As they are going to reach at the top of the level, they are finding that there is the snow covered ice is there. I hope that you all are understood till here. I must say that today we will read till here only. We will continue in our next lecture the remaining chapter. Okay, you just also read the chapter at home. If you have any kind of difficulty, you just tell in the next session. Be safe, stay home, stay safe. Take care of yourself and your families also. I think this is a good session to you all, and you must concentrate on this subject also. Clear?